Are aftermarket Tesla TPMS sensors a scam? If this is your first time watching, welcome to the channel. In this video, I'm going to showcase some aftermarket Tesla TPMS sensors and discuss the pros and cons of them. Is there really a difference? And are the Tesla sensors worth the price? Any Tesla from 2021 on is going to be equipped with Bluetooth TPMS sensors. As far as I know, at the time of this recording, Tesla's still the only manufacturer to use Bluetooth for TPMS instead of the standard 315 or 433 MHz sensors that other vehicles use. These sensors were only sold by Tesla for the first year until gray market sensors started hitting eBay. Sellers were getting these TPMS sensors from overseas, allegedly direct from where Tesla manufactures their sensors, and selling them at a significant discount, around 120 to 130 for a set of four. These sensors, to my eye, were identical to OEM and they didn't perform any differently. So I bought them and I recommended that a few of my friends do it too, and none of us have had any issues over the last few years. Then, predictably, aftermarket sensors finally started hitting the market, which is a good thing because Tesla wants $60 per sensor, which is less than the $95 they were asking before, which was absolutely insane. But 60 is more in line with what an OE TPMS sensor that's kind of unique in its own right should cost. Autel created a sensor, but it's still pretty expensive, around $50 to $60 a piece. It's still way too much money for a TPMS sensor when most standard OE sensors are $25 to $40 each. If you go on eBay today, even cheaper aftermarket sensors exist, but from what most would call no-name companies. These are very inexpensive, sometimes only $18 to $25 a piece. But they have no brand pedigree or long-term track record. These are what I'm going to showcase today, but before that, let's talk about the gray market sensors. eBay now has sensors that appear to be gray market and identical to OEM like they were in the past, but they're actually complete knockoffs. In some cases, there's no way to tell these from OEM, which is unfortunate because these used to be the best way to get original equipment TPMS sensors. Now it's totally a gamble, but is it still worth the risk? Yes and no. This is an Autel Maxi TPMS ITS 600, and is one of the few tools capable of scanning Bluetooth TPMS sensors. It won't show you if they're genuine, but it does show you if they work or not. And this is a box of seemingly no-name sensors that I got off of Amazon. Okay, we've got one unboxed. There were four sensors in there, and this is an aftermarket TPMS sensor, not one of the knockoffs. It doesn't claim to be anything it's not. There's no Tesla logo right there, though they do try to copy the blue color of the Tesla TPMS sensors. Also, this is a black stem. Tesla usually has a gray stem on theirs. You can also get silver, but this is clearly aftermarket. I'm glad that it's honest. So you know exactly what you're getting, but it's well built, it's solid. It's just not from Tesla. So let's scan it with the Autel and see what it says. I've got Tesla Model Y in there because they are all Bluetooth. Hit OK. Yes. Put the sensor up here near the sensor, hit trigger. Okay. We've got a unique hex ID. All TPMS sensors have those, and they are not the same. Zero PSI, because it's on my desk. 2.4 gigahertz, because it's Bluetooth. 69 degrees Fahrenheit in here. And the battery is okay. So really no different than what a 315 megahertz sensor would say. It's all the same data, but this just operates over Bluetooth, and it uses the car's built-in Bluetooth radio. That's where Tesla got some cost savings out of these, because they don't need to have their own TPMS antenna now. It can use the Bluetooth that's already in the vehicle. If this were a gray market sensor, it would have a Tesla logo on it, and it would look almost identical to OEM. In some cases, they are identical to OEM. They have a valve stem that matches the same exact colors, gray or silver, and all of the writing on the unit is identical, including the font. So it's very hard to tell gray market from aftermarket these days, but these are pretty reliable, and it's something I'd risk doing for the same price. If you don't know whether it's real or fake with the Tesla logo on it, it's probably a good bet to just take the gamble because they're a quarter of the price of what Tesla charges. So, what would I do? If you're one of the lucky ones that has your own tire equipment, get the cheapest possible sensors that you can. You might get lucky and they last many years. And if not, you could swap it out for free. For everyone else, I'd recommend the gray market eBay sensors as a safe middle ground. They're branded Tesla, they very well might be from Tesla, but you're only spending $130 instead of $400 for the set. This means that even if one fails prematurely, you're still ahead of the game even after paying for a mount and balance. Though a good tire shop shouldn't need to remove the tire from the wheel and can press the bead down with their tire machine to swap the sensor out. If money isn't an issue and you want total peace of mind, buying them direct from Tesla is still the way to go.